Blake stood off by saying that I love my dad. I miss him. So I wrote something down here. Hopefully it makes sense, so I'll just read it off. And I know my father will understand it, and I hope everybody else does too. Alright, so my father rescued me when I was 7 years old from a grim future, if not a very horrible present. And this rescue that he did brought my life never ending. So I was a little kid that was poor, was in was in an orphanage, and every kid's dream over there is that, one day somebody will come and, somebody will come and pick you up and take you off somewhere better. And when he came, first it wasn't known that he was there for me, so. It's just sort of a free for all the other kids. I'm just talking about the best behavior. Hey, take me. Well, obviously, I got lucky because here I am. A couple of fond memories I'd share with my father. When I first got here, he snows new to me. There's no snow in Brazil unless you go to the highest mountain, I suppose, but right, so I've never seen snow, and so I got here, and then something that really has always stayed with me is being out there clearing the driveway with my father on my favorite Tonka truck, and of course he was cheating with the snowblower, but I'd be out there just and I was so happy because I was helping him in the driveway with that. And then early mornings, I'd be drinking coffee, trying to avoid eating cereal before school. It's not big on cereal, but I love coffee. That was like when I was really little. So I got older. Father let me help in the garden, and I think that's really where we did a lot of our bonding. My father loved his gardening. One home pretty much had no yard; it was all garden. One of his memories is being in there with him, and I was actually learning about the shrubs and flowers that he was planting. Prior to that one, Dad had no interest in flowers and shrubs. I grew to like it and genuine interest. I even learned a few things about certain flowers, how to plant them and transplant them and care for them. My favorite activity, it turned out, was digging holes for trees and sometimes when he found one that he didn't like after all, I got to rip it out of the ground. And that to be rather exciting. there's that. There's a lot of happy times. There were some not so happy times where I'd get in trouble. Kids do. I think I got in trouble a little more than most. And even at that, when I get in trouble at school, and I think back on that, I still have to smile because part of my punishment was having to be in his classroom while he's at work. Maybe at home, so I'm too little, but somehow that didn't seem like a punishment to me. And then I was sitting there at the back of his class with my dinky cutters, and he's teaching his class, of course, and I'm just sitting there quietly playing away my dinky cutters. So I know I'm supposed to be being punished, but again, to me, that is something that I hold and makes me smile, and you know, I'll be thinking about that even more over, over time as, since he's not here physically. I know I wasn't always very good in, like, you know, behavior, and I know it made him sad at times, but I hope that in my adult life I showed him that, you know, he raised me pretty well, and the mistakes I make were mine and my own, and nothing to do reflect on his inability to raise me. I hope I conveyed that to him too before he went. And in parting, I hope that he's up there and God gave him a good chunk of garden. To, you know, to play in. So I think that's the only way my father knew how to relax. Because anything else, he always had to work, he always had to do something. Hopefully he's got a good section of garden, and he's got a couple trees for me to rip out when I see my turn. So I love my father, and I want to thank everybody for being here. And I know that, that you're as much part of his family. I know he loved his very much, and that makes you part of my family, and I appreciate everything. And thank you, and pray for all of us. Thank you.
Okay, so did you have any